This is a Mid-Pacific Region Public Affairs production.
The Central Valley Project in California delivers an annual average of more than 5 million acre-feet of water. The CVP's complex network of dams, reservoirs, canals, and natural rivers extend 400 miles, from the snowy mountains of the north to the semi-arid Central Valley. The water flows to agriculture in the Sacramento and San Joaquin Valleys, to farmland in California's Central Coast region, to wildlife refuges, and to urban areas in the southern and eastern San Francisco Bay Area. Near the midpoint of the CVP, the rivers flow into the Sacramento-San Joaquin Delta. At the southern end of the delta, water is pumped uphill into the Delta Mendota Canal to continue flowing south into the San Joaquin Valley. But an essential facility stands between the fish in the delta waters and the pumping plant and canal, the Tracy Fish Collection Facility. There are dozens of fish in the delta that are considered threatened or endangered. The facility was built in the 1950s to protect fish from entering the CVP pumps and the canal. Reclamation is continually developing and implementing new technologies for collecting fish, holding them, then transporting them north and releasing them back into the delta.
The Tracy Fish Collection Facility is a critical component of the Central Valley Project. Without it, the Jones Pumping Plant would not be able to export water out of the South Delta. A lot of what occurs here is driven by the State Water Resources Control Board standards and federal biological opinions.
Fish entering the facility are collected through a maze of channels, louvers, bypasses, pipes, screens, and holding tanks that can only be appreciated by viewing a side cutaway of the complex structure.
We're in the South Delta, and we take water off the old San Joaquin River, and we pump that through the fish facility to the Jones Pumping Plant. We take approximately 50 different species a year at the facility. Most of the time we're taking about 20. Little fish can pass with the water flow through the trash rack, and the larger fish, then 40 centimeters, which is approximately that large, stay out in front of the facility. The little fish come in through the trash rack and enter the primary channel, which is 84 feet across. The fish in the primary channel are pushed downstream by water flow. The faster the water flow, the faster they're pushed downstream. As the fish are being pushed downstream, they sense a primary channel louver system that is like a Venetian blind with 1-inch slats. They want to avoid the louvers, and they enter into 4 bypasses. These bypasses have 6-inch wide openings, and they transition into an underground pipe. Fish enter the secondary channel in about 130 cubic feet per second. That's too much water to screen. So we use another set of louvers in the secondary channel to condense fish to one side of the channel. The louvers, we condense them to one side of the channel where they're carried off into the holding tank. The fish entering the holding tank are stored for 8 to 12 hours, and the fish are condensed on the outer area of the holding tank. Water passes through the screen in the center and down a drain. Every 8 to 12 hours, we drain the tank. We put the fish in a fish haul truck, which is about 2,400 gallons, and then we transport them up to the North Delta by Sherman Island.
Here in the holding tank building, we track and record the number of fish that we salvage here at the fish collection facility. We do so by doing 10-minute samples, 30-minute samples every couple hours. We hand count the fish during those sample periods, and then we expand the numbers to give us total salvage numbers for the day. Here at the fish count station is where we do our 10-minute counts and our 30-minute counts. We take the samples, we empty them into the bin, and then we hand count the samples and we record it on our data sheets over here. Another part of the operations here at the Tracy Fish Collection facility involves our on-site research effort, where we are studying different components of the salvage operation so that we can improve the overall efficiency. We use the aquaculture facility to hold the fish that we use in our tests. These fish come either from hatcheries or from our salvage stock. Studies that we do on site here, we do whole facility efficiency tests where we insert tags in fish and we track them throughout the facility. We also do predator removal studies, holding tank studies, secondary channel studies. We try to break up the process into components so that we can learn about each component of the process.
Tanker trucks are filled in preparation for transporting the fish salvaged at the facility. The water is oxygenated for hauling large loads of fish. Once the truck has hauled the fish to the central delta, they are poured from the truck into a funnel attached to a large pipe. The fish flow into the tunnel and out into natural waters. Even as fish are restored to the central delta, others are entering the Tracy Fish Collection facility at its southern end in the never-ending cycle. A cycle that is essential to protection of fish and continuing operation of the Central Valley Project.